Belgium delivered one of the finest World Cup comebacks to break Japanese hearts in the last 16 of the World Cup. Not since West Germany defeated England 3-2 in the 1970 finals in Mexico had a side come back from 2 goals down in a knockout tie. But Roberto Martinez's men did just that in Rostov-on-Don, with Nathair Chadli scoring a 94th-minute winner after a stunning counter-attack to ensure the Red Devils, somewhat miraculously, reached the quarter-finals. Goals from Genki Haraguchi and Takashi Inoue had put Japan 2-0 up early in the second half and left Belgium on the brink. Image, Getty Images Europe. Image, Getty Images Europe. But Belgium showed the kind of mentality that's been lacking all too often. Image, 2018 Getty Images. Jan Vertonghen's deflected cross gave them hope before substitute Marouane Fellaini headed in to level the scores, with the tie heading for extra time. Belgium delivered a clinical counter as Romelu Lukaku dummied Thomas Meunier's cross for Chadli to slide in. They will now face Brazil in the last 8 on Friday. Martinez must make De Bruyne a decision. De Bruyne again operated from a deep midfield role. Image, 2018 Getty Images. Kevin De Bruyne is a fabulous footballer, capable of playing in a variety of roles. Unfortunately for him, that means having to play in a deep position for this Belgium side when his talents would surely be better served playing higher up the field. The Manchester City man's third appearance in Russia again came at the heart of Roberto Martinez's 3-4-3 formation. With De Bruyne operating alongside Axel Witsel as a sitting midfield, throw in the lack of mobility of his partner, who now plies his trade in China, and De Bruyne finds himself operating as a venerable dog's body in midfield, unable to push too far forwards for fear of leaving space that Witsel is unable to cover. With De Bruyne playing alongside N'Golo Kante, a player who covers every blade of grass, then he'd be more liberated. However, restrained, he was left to underwhelm against a tenacious Japanese display, until he cast off the shackles with his role in the winner. He needs to be allowed to do that more often. 2-0 on Wii with Inoue. Inoue celebrates finding the net. Image, Reuters. Takashi Inoue has spent much of his career with a point to prove. He turned professional with Yokohama F. Marinos in his homeland, before being sent on loan to a lower division with Cerezo Osaka. 20 goals in the 2009 season led them to Japan's top flight, where he impressed and subsequently earned a move to Germany with Fell Borken. However, he had to go to the second tier again and prove himself, before he could take the step up into the Bundesliga with Eintracht Frankfurt. 3 years later, he moved to AVA, the La Liga Minnows, and after 3 years with them has this summer's got a move to one of Spain's grandest clubs, Real Betis. At the age of 30, Inoue has shown his class at this World Cup. A talented ball player, he's cool in possession, technically extremely gifted, always seemingly has time on the ball, and is capable of producing magic. His goal and performance was excellent and he didn't deserve to see his World Cup end in Rostov. 3. The Roberto Martinez conundrum. Martinez's side have it all to prove. Image, AFP. Is it better to be a good coach or a lucky one? Roberto Martinez is really testing the theory that it may be better to be the latter. For 65 minutes the Spaniard was outmaneuvered by his opposite number, Akira Nishiro. Nishiro had clearly done his homework and his side were set up to take advantage of the space in behind Belgium's wing-backs and the immobile Witsel, through the clever movement of Kagawa, Inoue and Haraguchi. His response was to replace the ineffective Dries Mertens with Marouane Fellaini's aerial threat and power and go more direct, aka the Jose Mourinho. Within 4 minutes, Jan Vertonghen's cross looped in and gave them a foothold in the game out of nowhere. 5 minutes after that, Martinez's Manchester United trump card headed home to make it 2-2 and then they were firmly in the ascendancy. Fellaini heads home the equaliser. Image, Rex/Shutterstock. However, they then slackened, when Japan appeared there for the taking, and extra time loomed. That was until a blistering counter, led by De Bruyne, who is so shackled by Martinez's use of him as a holding midfielder but was able to do what he does best for the first time in the 94th minute, and finished by Nathair Chadli, a player who barely played for West Brom last season but to whom Martinez is loyal. Is he a good manager? Is he a lucky one? Or is the answer somewhere in between? 4. Belgium have it all to prove against Brazil. Celebrate good times, come on, image. 2018 Getty Images. Look at Belgium's form in recent years. Sure, their last defeat came on September 1, 2016, but can you name a really good side that they have beaten? The answer is no, simply because they haven't played any. The last time they met a really elite side came in 2016, where they lost to Italy at the Euros when Antonio Conte and the Azzurri did a job on them. Post-Euros they played Spain and David Silva put in a sterling performance as Martinez lost his opening match in charge. They thrashed Gibraltar, Estonia, Saudi Arabia etc. They talk a big game off the field, players this week mentioning how they aren't scared of Brazil. Now, after all the talk, they get to walk the walk. They'll need to be a darn sight better than they were in Rostov. 5. What a counter-attack. Chadli wheels away after finding the net. Image, 2018 Getty Images. When it mattered, when it truly mattered, Belgium showed that they had the stomach for the fight, coming back to win 3-2. And in the 94th minute, they produced a textbook counter-attacking goal to seal their quarter-final place. Did Japan overcommit at the corner? Perhaps. But when Thibaut Courtois claimed the corner from the right, what then happened was simply magnificent. From his quick bowl out, to De Bruyne's surge through the centre and pass to Meunier, his low ball, Lukaku's dummy, after some of the best centre-forward movement you could possibly wish to see, and then Chadli's finish. It was simply